بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وبه نستعين أما بعد respected guests prominent teachers and dear audience today I am honored to deliver a speech on the topic of waqf what is waqf waqf is an islamic endowment of property to be held in trust and used for a charitable or religious purposes The term waqf comes from the Arabic word meaning confinement or prohibition. In simpler terms, it means dedicating property in the name of God for religious or charitable purposes. In Islam, just as worship and servitude to Allah hold special importance, so does helping others. That is why, along with the prayer and fasting, the commands for zakat and sadaqatul fitr are also given. If a person makes a mistake, there is room for compensation through financial expression, meaning feeding the poor and clothing them. One form of charity is to temporarily fulfill the need of a needy person, like feeding a hungry person, providing clothes for someone who needs them. Another form is to do such an act of goodness that benefits many people and continues for a long time. Although both forms are acts of reward, but the second one carries more reward because the benefit reaches more people and lasts longer. The Messenger of Allah said, when a person dies, their deeds end, except for three cases. Sadaqah Jariyah, continuous charity, knowledge that benefits others, a righteous child who prays for them. Here, Sadaqah Jariyah refers to such an act done by a person that continues to benefit others even after their death. Like contributing to the construction of mosques, educational institutions, publishing religious books, or doing any good deed for travelers and orphans. All such good deeds are included in Sadaqah Jariyah. Another form of Sadaqah Jariyah is waqf, where the original asset is retained and its benefits are spent on the deserving as per the donor's wish. This shows the importance and reward of waqf. Dear audience, it's clear that neither the property of donor remains with him after waqf, nor does it belong to the trustee or those who benefit from it. The concept of waqf in Islamic law is that it belongs directly to Allah. In Islam, not only worship is a rewarded act, but also serving humanity. Therefore, the scope of waqf is very wide. For example, just as endowing things that benefit the poor is valid, so is the waqf, from which both poor and rich people can benefit. Even creating waqf for one's own children is correct. Thus, madrasas, mosques, orphanages, charitable organizations for the aid of the poor, religious or modern educational institutions, publishing religious books and organizations established for such purposes are all waqf properties. Because of the importance of waqf, Muslims have always endowed properties for various good deeds. There is a bright history of this in the Muslim community. In India, there are so many waqf properties that if they were used properly and their benefits given to Muslims, all educational and economic issues of Muslims could be solved. Currently, due to mismanagement, about 50% of waqf properties are occupied by the government and non-Muslim citizens. It is the duty of the government to protect waqf properties just as it respects personal and public properties, and make their recovery easier and certain by law. However, it is possible for the government to force them to pay rent so that the waqf's objectives and Muslim interests can be served. Similarly, many government offices and buildings are on waqf land and their rent should be substantial considering their location. The government should pay rent to the waqf board for such occupied properties. If appropriate rent is paid to the waqf board, the education of poor Muslims, support for orphans, care for devout and widowed women, and employment training for unemployed youth could be easily resolved. And they could be freed from begging in front of the government. Now, the current government wants to amend the waqf act, considering reducing the powers of the waqf board with 40 amendments on the horizon. There is a serious concern that these amendments will weaken the waqf act and the workforce established in different states will be weakened. If this happens, it will be very damaging to the work properties, and protecting the widespread work properties across the country will become difficult. That is why we Muslims demand the government not to make any amendments to the Work Act that would weaken it or make protection uncertain. We clarify our stance that any change in the Work Act 2013 that alters the nature or the status of work properties or makes it easier for the government or individuals to usurp them will not be acceptable. Likewise, reducing or limiting the powers of the work boards will not be tolerated. And with this, I conclude my speech by saying we should wholeheartedly strive to protect the work board, and I pray to Allah that He accepts our humble efforts. Ameen. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi.